I'm Norm Macdonald, and this is Kitty. This is my memoir. I thought I would read you the introduction. Found alive in a hotel room in Edmonton. You're dead. The hell I am, they'll see. I've heard this kind of talk before. How I'm finished, through, obsolete, passé. Yesterday's news has been fossil. I'll have you know I'm just as relevant today as I was 20 years ago, I say. No, no, my agent laughs through the phone like it's the greatest joke in the world. He says, check your Wikipedia page. You're dead, all right. Well, I look around the room. I see the small bottles that are scattered everywhere. Those small bottles that make me feel so big. They're empty now, of course, just like me. My suitcase is in the corner. Same one I've had my whole career. I was all beat to hell, stitching coming out of the side. But it still does its job. Sort of. See, stand-up comedy is a shabby business, made up of shabby fellows like me who cross the country, stay in shabby hotels, and tell jokes they no longer find funny. You show up in a strange town, then you're gone. Then another town. Another. Then another. Then a thousand more. Then another. You're moving. You're always moving. Like some sort of criminal drifter. Getting what you can from a place and getting out. You're never in a place long enough to experience anything but the shabbiest of love. I turned to look at the girl next to me in bed. Must have met her last night at the comedy club, where they had a great tall picture of me leaning against the door to remind people that I used to be a big shot. I was once, you know. Her hair is bright yellow, her lips are bright red, and she'll wake up soon, and I'll pretend that I remember her. I make my way quietly through the dim room to the wide-open minibar. It's empty but for one tiny bottle. Way in the back. I always leave one. I drink her dry, the way a man puts gas in his car when the tank's near empty, just to keep going a little longer down that endless road. Damn near 50. Over at the table, I hit a couple of buttons on my computer and discover what my agent found so funny. See, some jokers changed my Wikipedia. My Wikipedia page, all right? He's left me for dead. Norm Macdonald, it reads. October 17th, 1963 to May 12th, 2013 was a comedian and actor who was known from Saturday. I read on till the final sentence. The death sentence. Mr. Macdonald was found dead in an Edmonton hotel room. An overdose of morphine. Well, that's a sight to see, all right. With all the authority of the internet behind it, I'm standing stock still in the very same Edmonton hotel where I died the night before. And then I started to laugh. I laughed a beat all get out, just like my agent did. Just because I'm alive and I can. Then a thought comes to me in a sudden. A thought that stops all my laughing. Makes me real cold. It has me craving a couple of grams of morphine, to tell you the truth, or at least some whiskey. And the thought is this. The preposterous lie on the screen before me isn't that far off. After all, the only thing this joker really did was change tenses, see? He turned does to did, is to was. He got the date of my passing wrong, but nothing else. To misquote Mark Twain, it turns out the rumor of my death is only slightly exaggerated. So now I start to read this thing on the computer again, only this time I read it the way I imagine a stranger would. Actually will in some years from now or some decades, when it's true, in the future, when I was Norm Macdonald. So, this is my life then? These words on the screen? Well, it doesn't add up to much, just a series of facts. And I suppose that's what a man's life is, after all, but it's more than that, too, isn't it? I mean, it has to be, doesn't it? And so I decide I will write an account of my life story, my own self, my side of the story. Damn near 50. The girl on the bed is beginning to stir now, and I feel sorry for her. Same way I feel sorry for myself every time I have to wake up. I struggle to remember her name. That's no good. And I look at her and wonder who we were last night. And that's when I come up with a title for my book. I'll call it Based on a True Story. Because it comes to me that there's no way of telling a true story. I mean, a really true one. Because of the memory, see? There's no good. It's like when a guy's telling a story and he's way off. And you know he's way off because the whole story's about you. But he's changing it all around. Leaving out important parts, making up others from whole cloth, doing whatever he has to turn the dead stuff of life into some more talent. And you'd correct him. The thing is, you're not sure you remember it 100% accurately yourself. See, it turns out your memory isn't the precise court stenographer that you think it is, getting every word down just so. See, your memory's more like a sketch artist way at the back of the courtroom who's doing his level best to capture images that no longer are. So, it won't be a true story. It'll be based on a true story. Like every story I've ever told. But I promise you this, it'll be the truth. Every word of it. Man, to the best of my memory, I will not just scratch the surface. No siree, Bob. I'll claw and tear into this show business career of mine, and I'll let the filth fly like a mad dog digging up bones he buried deep and long ago. And I'll name names, and I'll drop bombshells. I bet they'll pay good money for that kind of thing. For the straight dope and the Hollywood crowd and the SNLers too. I need money. I need money to live. Damn near 50. I open up the curtains and it's raining outside. I catch an image of myself in the window. And the rain blurs my thin reflection as if I'm barely there at all. And I see there's a bruise under my left eye and some dried blood. Then I look down at my hand and the heel of my thumb is swollen purple. Hurts like a bastard. That makes me happy. It means the girl on the bed was fought for and not bought. She's full of weight now. She's holding her head, squinting, and I watch her as she sees me. I can tell her. I can tell she doesn't remember anything either. Well, that's okay. I'll hear her. All about it later from the guy who runs the comedy club downstairs, and I'll sit and I'll listen, transfixed, the forgotten details of last night, and I'll shake my head, bewildered, feeling like a trespasser in my own life. I'll look at the girl squarely. I'll get us a bottle. She has a pretty smile. That was the intro.